You guys want to honor Kevin Pearson? Let's honor him.
In episode number one, we see him kind of hit rock bottom. He's trying to figure himself out, and he's kind of doing a poor job of it. He's struggling in every way, shape, and form. He's developed this substance abuse problem. He's suffering from depression. Kevin is this guy that's kind of in a crowded room, and he's completely alone. For me, it wasn't so much about the inebriation as much as it was about the pain. And he's self-medicating. So he's coming off of these drugs, and he's got to find a way to try to feel better. And I just saw him as searching so hard to find answers and open to listening, but no one was willing to accept that this guy actually needed help. I mean, if I sit and think about it, I'll get emotional. To think that someone is in that place of need, and yet as loud as they can scream, they still have no voice because no one's really listening to what the hell is actually going on.
He's got a man open, wide open. He sees his entire future.
I remember getting myself in a place sort of mentally, and what if this guy could have one more conversation with his dad? And I remember thinking this, I believe that if Jack was there, if his dad was there, if he could have one more conversation with him that lasted more than 10 seconds, he could probably make it all better. That space in between what that could have been, what it should have been, and what it is where I kind of operated. So I didn't look at it as kind of me just talking to no one. I looked at it as him talking to one very specific person. And it's exhausting and it's emotional, but I feel like that's where it needed to be. No more, no less.
That necklace belonged to my father, okay?
I do this thing where I just listen to the words that people are saying to me when I'm in a scene, and you listen to the words that are coming out of your mouth and what you're trying to get and what you really don't have and what it represents, this necklace. That was his dad, right? If you just think about that, it's the saddest thing in the world.
I'm in pain out here!
Ken Olin and our team of camera operators and our DP figure out a way to create a space for you to just kind of do your thing. You don't have to think about the camera. You don't have to think about the framing or the lighting or anything. You just kind of know if you're in this space here, kind of do your thing, and then we'll figure it out. The major reason I think this episode is so important is because there are people out there, really good people, that are going through this very real, difficult thing. Drug addiction, mental illness, depression. These are things, when I read this episode, this was something that was sort of bigger than just the show. I wanted it to be real and honest, so.